you could make it today in the church. Today we're going to go through what we do every Sunday before we start the Vadara, before we start the Divine Liturgy. And today, I just finished doing the incense for the service, and of course we've talked about that before. Today, we're going to do a special section on how I get vested, what I do to get vested before. Vested, of course, means getting dressed. Remember we talked about it last week? Special clothes that we wear for the liturgy. Well, now you're going to see what the meaning of those vestments are. Vestments, the special clothes that we wear. So I'm going to ask you now, come with me into the vestry. This is called the vestry. Come on. Come on. This is on Sunday morning. This is what happens every Sunday morning before church starts. Deacon Rafi is here. How are you, Deacon?
I'm doing fine, thank you. How are you?
Good. Deacon Rafi is here every Sunday to assist me in getting vested. Now you're going to see what the meaning of all these vestments are. First of all, I take off my viragu, which is this black robe, and my lanchachach. The lanchachach is a very special cross that not all priests get to wear. The bishop has to give you the right to wear this. And last year, after 10 years of being a priest, our bishop gave me the right to wear this lanchachach. So first I take this off. And then I take off my viragu. Now before every vestment that's given to me, the deacon says something. What Deacon Rafi said was a very short litany that we always say throughout the church. It says, "Let us in peace ask the Lord, bless, save, and receive us." And the priest says, "Blessings and glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit." On every vestment that he puts on, the first thing that he puts on is the tak, which is the crown. And the symbol of the tak, or the crown, is that now the priest is going to into a service whereby he is presented as the king to the people, much like Jesus who came here as the king. And the prayer that he reads, this is the prayer book. On each vestment, the priest has to recite one of these prayers. First one, it says, "Put this this crown of salvation on my head so that I can combat all the enemies." And we know who those enemies are, those invisible people that come to us and tell us all those bad things. The next thing is the shabik. Now, we all know that word. It means shabik. But for us, the white one is a very special one. The shabik symbolizes purity. And so the priest can be... Since the priest is just a human being, he has all kinds of faults, and he also commits sins. But the idea is that by putting on the shabik, not that his sins are forgiven, but that he is putting on a new garment, a new piece of clothing, to say that we are now going to go in purity on the altar. Purity, cleanliness. The next thing is called hod urar. This is a regular urar that Deacon Rafi is wearing. When you're a deacon, you get the right to wear the urar. The por urar goes over your pori. Okay? Por urar just comes on like this. The idea here is another garment of service, just like the urar just symbolizes that I am now a servant here to serve the people. Called a kodi. Kodi is a belt. And the belt is there as a reminder to remind me that I am in this service. That as I feel it against me, I am always reminded that I am here as a servant to serve the people and help the people. The next ones are called pasbans. This is the pazul. And these are pasbans.
Okay.
Symbol of this is, since we're going into the service, much like a gladiator, he puts on these special things. These are there to give me the strength to do the work of God. So these give my hands strength to do God's work. The next one is called a bagas. Bagas. Now, you may have heard the word bagas. Bagas means less. This is bagas. Okay?
You give us all the time.
This one has a very special rule. When the priest puts the bagas on, what he's showing here is that maybe if you remember on the farm, if any of you have lived on the farm, how the horses have blinders so that they can't look other places. The bagas has a similar function. It's to remind the priest that his concentration must be toward the altar, towards his service to the people, and not be looking around at who came to church, what they're wearing, what they're doing. It reminds the priest that his concentration should be up there. And when you see the bagas, it should remind you as well that your concentration should be to God for this few minutes that you're in church, and not all around and looking around and seeing who's who and what they're doing. Now, that's a big problem, I know, but it's one of the good ones that we have to always remember. Finally, this is called the shurchad. Now, the shurchad is like a shield that the priest puts upon him. The priest always kisses the shurchad because this is a very holy thing. This is part of his vestments. The last part, and like I said, it's a shield. Again, when we go to do this service, be shielded against any enemies. And you know, we have all kinds of enemies. When we say enemies, it's not the people who don't like us, but there's also different forces that try to play upon us, that try to give us evil thoughts. And when evil, it's just things that mean that, like when we don't help each other, when we don't love each other, those kind of things. We want to keep all those kind of thoughts away from us. Finally, the talk which we had earlier, we put on our head. But before we do this one, again, the lanchachach, which some priests get to wear, I put this one on as a reminder that my bishop gave this to me. And this is a cross, and we know the symbol of the cross. And we put on the tuck. Another name for the tuck is sahabar, but we use the word tuck. So this is what the priest looks like. And of course, you see me after everything is finished, and we do the service over there. So this is called vesting, and today you got a special privilege to be in here in this vestry. The privilege was mine that I got to be with you today. So now we're going to go up and start the service. I'll see you again next week, and thank you for sending me those questions, because they're great, and I'm going to get to them next week again. This was part of your questions were about what I wear, and so I hope today we answered them. God bless you all, and I'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.